Well, it's Workout Wednesday on our noon show today, and Joshua's here to teach us some exercises that you guys can join in at home with, and it's all for low back pain. So how many people come into Crossroads Fitness and complain about some low back pain?
It's really common, particularly with people who work desk jobs or spend a lot of time driving. Just anything where you sit a lot, it's going to put your low back in a position where over time it's going to wear out and all those tissues are going to get irritated, inflamed, which leads to that chronic low back pain. It's really common.
And so building up the muscle back there, does that help combat that issue?
Yeah, absolutely. So the muscles that most support your low back are going to be the glutes, which is your butt muscles there. Getting those as strong as possible is only going to help to support the low back and keep it in a strong position.
That makes sense. It all kind of ties together at the end of the day, right? Okay, so we're going to get on the floor and show you guys some of these exercises now. Join in at home. Let us know what you think. All right, how are we going to start?
Great, so the first one is called a press up, or in yoga it's called cobra pose.
Okay.
You're gonna lay down on your stomach. There's a few different intensities to this one, so I'll start with the easiest and then you'll go up to more difficult.
Okay.
The easiest is to go right here on your elbows, and you're just gonna relax as much as you can, let your hips relax down towards the floor.
Okay.
And you might feel a little bit of a stretch right there. You're looking for a light to moderate intensity kind of stretch.
For sure.
From there, if you want to go more intense, your hands are going to go out in front of you a little ways. Good.
Okay.
And you're going to smooth and controlled press up, hold it for about 2 seconds, and relax back down.
Okay.
If you want more intense from there, you just bring your hands back and press up. So once again, you're looking for a light to moderate stretch. If it's really intense, or if you find you can't straighten your arms all the way, that means you need to relax a little bit.
So you're going for arms being straightened, that nice kind of curve in your low back, which feels so nice.
Yeah.
And you, is there anything else we should be looking out for? Should our core be squeezed or anything like that?
Actually, on this one, you want to relax as much as possible, and you'll hold at the top for 2 or 3 seconds and go for 10 reps.
Gotcha.
That's
okay, so you want to do 10 reps. That makes sense. Okay.
Okay.
That's pretty easy. Like that.
So the next one, you'll go over to your back.
Okay.
This is a stretch for your hamstrings. So you lay on your back, one leg goes flat, the other one, you're gonna support your thigh, so your upper leg is just going straight up and down in the air. Relax, and you kick your leg straight up, pull the toe down.
Okay.
Hold that 2 or 3 seconds, and relax the leg all the way down, and back up again.
Gotcha.
This looks easy, but it's actually a pretty intense stretch. You'll do about 10 to 15 reps on each leg, and you'll start to feel a real good burn right on the front of your thigh, which is really good.
I was about to say my quad. Yeah, I definitely feel that in there.
Great. So from there, the next exercise, you're going to bring your heels so they're about 6 or so inches from your hips.
Okay.
Get set. Draw your belly button back towards your spine so you get some tension in your stomach. And all at once, you're going to push your hips up. So you get in a line from your shoulders to your knees, hold it 2 or 3 seconds, and go back down.
And in yoga classes, like we were kind of talking beforehand, I always hear them say one vertebrae at a time. When you're releasing out of that, do you want to be moving pretty slowly?
Yeah, I think that's a good way of looking at it.
Yeah.
Going up, control it at the top, and just focus on good, smooth control all the way down, because that's only going to help to get the muscles stronger and more stable for your low back.
These are all some good tips that you guys can, I mean, you could really do this any time of day. You could definitely do it while you're just hanging out at home, kind of having a nice afternoon, hopefully. But so that will do it for our low back pain workouts. Now, Crossroads has been nice enough to come on the noon show, and we're going to be doing these Workout Wednesday segments pretty regularly. So if you guys want any more exercises, any tips, any questions at all, please don't hesitate to call Joshua or anyone down at Crossroads Fitness, and they can help you out. But we'll have all this information for you posted on westernslopenow.com.